بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our case study today, this infant is at increased risk of. This is clinical assessment. If you see here, this is hand, and there is actually a soft tissue swelling with discoloration of the hand at the wrist joint. You see, actually it's due to extravasation, due to calcium infiltrations. If you, this is the clinical assessment. If you see up here in the X-ray, after that, if you see there is radio opaque shadow here, radio opaque shadow, it's due to calcium infiltration and soft tissue swelling, and the radii and ulnar actually is present. If you see the X-ray here, this is extravasation swelling. If you see here, this is the calcium infiltrations. So this infant is increased risk of A, bleeding. Why we thinking about bleeding of this patient, if especially in the limb X-ray? Because if there is no radius and there is thrombocytopenia, it will call it TAR syndrome. TAR syndrome, thrombocytopenia with absent radius. But here the radius is present, so is not goes with TAR syndrome in this case. Heart problem, for sure heart problem also is, it will be Holt-Oram or Fanconi anemia. It will be associated with Holt-Oram with ASCD and deficiency or aplasia of the thumb and abnormalities or hypoplasia or deficiency of the radii. Gross delay, it will be due to Fanconi anemia, but this is not the case because the radius and the thumb is present, so is out of differential diagnosis of Fanconi or Holt-Oram or TAR syndrome. Fracture also is not the case, so the answer it will be the E is none of the above. So this case of radio opaque shadow due to calcium infiltration and extravasations is not associated with bleeding or heart problems or gross delay, because all of this it will be associated with TAR syndrome or Holt-Oram or Fanconi anemia. If you see here, this is the clinical assessment. As we mentioned before, this soft tissue swelling due to extravasations, and there is discoloration in the wrist area. If you see here, this is the radiological assessment, calcium extravasation. If you see here, this is the calcium infiltrations after extravasation of the calcium from the IV fluid. So clinical assessment is soft tissue swelling, and radiological assessment radio opaque shadow due to calcium infiltrations. If you see here, this is Holt-Oram. What is Holt-Oram? Holt-Oram, it will be associated with skeletal abnormalities and hand abnormalities, hand and heart. Holt-Oram, heart and hand. Hand, it will be aplasia or hypoplasia of the thumb, and the radius also it will be aplasia or hypoplasia of the radius, and will be associated with cardiac abnormalities. And most common cardiac abnormalities associated with Holt-Oram, it will be ASCD. Here, this is TAR syndrome. TAR, it is called thrombocytopenia with absent radius. But our case, the thumb and the radius, it's present actually. So this is not of the case. And also the TAR syndrome, it will be associated with bleeding disorder because the thrombocytopenia and megakaryocyte. If you see here the Fanconi anemia, for sure it will be associated with microcephaly, developmental delay, hypopigmentation, caffeolate, craniofacial abnormalities, microphthalmia, ptosis, strabismus, and actually it, the cardiac it will be VSD and the renal horse show kidneys, and the skeletal will be radial abnormalities and thumb abnormalities. Radial and thumb abnormalities will be Fanconi. But our case, actually the radii and the thumb, it's present actually. So this is against to choose the TAR syndrome or to choose Fanconi anemia. It's not Fanconi syndrome. Fanconi syndrome, so, other issues, it will be renal abnormalities. But Fanconi anemia, this is the Fanconi anemia, CNS abnormalities, craniofacial, cardiac, renal, and skeletal abnormalities. So our case is the answer, it will be E, is none of the above, not bleeding, not developmental delay, not other associated with skeletal abnormalities. So our objective from this case, just for interpretation of the limb x-ray. Once you see the limb x-ray, you have to concentrate about the radius and thumb. Because if there is absent radius or absent thumb or hypoplasia of the radius or hypoplasia of the thumb or radius or abnormalities in the radii or the thumb, it will be associated with specific syndrome, and common syndrome it will be TAR, thrombocytopenia with absent radius, or Fanconi anemia, or Holt Oram. Holt Oram, heart and hand, and here aplasia of the thumb or hypoplasia of the radii and ASCD cardiac abnormalities. So our case, if you see the critical assessment here, the radii, the radius and thumb both are present. So TAR syndrome and Fanconi anemia less likely. This is extravasation of the calcium containing fluid in the soft tissue gives radio opaque shadow. How to treat such cases? You have to stop the injection, the calcium infusions, and you have to remove the line, and you have to notify the medical staff about the case for documentations, and you have to elevate the extremities for at least 48 hours, and depend on the medication you give. Shall we give apply warm or cold packs, and you have to administer hyaluronidase or phentolamines. It will help for prevent the extravasation and infiltrations, and will help for the generation of the tissues. For sure, any event like this, you have to document it in the file and to have you to monitor your patient. Shukran, salam alaikum.